The Importance of Meditation. The Baha'i Faith.
Meditate profoundly, that the secret of the things unseen may be revealed unto you, that you may inhale the sweetness of a spiritual and imperishable fragrance, and that you may acknowledge the truth, that from time immemorial, even unto eternity, the Almighty hath tried, and will continue to try, His servants, so that light may be distinguished from darkness, truth from falsehood, right from wrong, guidance from error, happiness from misery, and roses from thorns, the Kitab-e-Iqan.
O brother, we should open our eyes, meditate upon His word, and seek the sheltering shadow of the manifestations of God. The Kitab-e-Iqan.
In this consisteth the complete surrender of one's will to the will of God. Meditate on this, that thou mayest drink in the waters of everlasting life, which flow through the words of the Lord of all mankind, and mayest testify that the one true God hath ever been immeasurably exalted above His creatures. Gleanings from the writings of Baha'u'llah.
If any man were to meditate on that which the Scriptures, sent down from the heaven of God's holy will, have revealed, he would readily recognize that their purpose is that all men shall be regarded as one soul, so that the seal bearing the words, "The kingdom shall be God's," may be stamped on every heart, and the light of divine bounty, of grace and mercy, may envelop all mankind. Gleanings from the writings of Baha'u'llah.
Meditate diligently upon the cause of thy Lord. Strive to know Him through His own self and not through others, for no one else besides Him can ever profit thee. To this all created things will testify, couldst thou but perceive it? Gleanings from the writings of Baha'u'llah.
Do thou meditate on that which we have revealed unto thee, that thou mayest discover the purpose of God, thy Lord, and the Lord of all worlds. In these words the mysteries of divine wisdom have been treasured. Gleanings from the writings of Baha'u'llah.
Whenever I pause to meditate upon the oceans of thy bounteousness, and the heaven of thy grace, and the day star of thy tender compassion, I inhale the fragrance of hope diffused from right and left, from north and south, as if every created thing imparteth unto me the joyous tidings that the clouds of the heaven of thy mercy will pour down their rain upon me. Tablets of Baha'u'llah, revealed after the Kitab-e-Aqdas.
Happy is the man that pondereth in his heart that which hath been revealed in the books of God, the help in peril, the self-subsisting. Meditate upon this, O ye beloved of God, and let your ears be attentive unto His word, so that ye may, by His grace and mercy, drink your fill from the crystal waters of constancy, and become as steadfast and immovable as the mountain in His cause. Proclamation of Baha'u'llah.
It is incumbent upon you to ponder in your hearts and meditate upon His words, and humbly to call upon Him, and to put away self in His heavenly cause. These are the things that will make you signs of guidance unto all mankind, and brilliant stars shining down from the all-highest horizon, and towering trees in the Abha paradise. Selections from the writings of Abdul Baha.
Baha'u'llah says there is a sign from God in every phenomenon. The sign of the intellect is contemplation, and the sign of contemplation is silence, because it is impossible for a man to do two things at one time. He cannot both speak and meditate. Paris talks. You cannot apply the name man to any being void of this faculty of meditation. Through the faculty of meditation, man attains to eternal life. Through it he receives the breath of the Holy Spirit. The bestowal of the Spirit is given in reflection and meditation. Paris talks.
The spirit of man is itself informed and strengthened during meditation. Through it, affairs of which man knew nothing are unfolded before his view. Through it, he receives divine inspiration. Through it, he receives heavenly food. Paris talks.
Meditation is the key for opening the doors of mysteries. In that state, man abstracts himself. In that state, man withdraws himself from all outside objects. In that subjective mood, he is immersed in the ocean of spiritual life and can unfold the secrets of things in themselves. This faculty brings forth, from the invisible plane, the sciences and arts. Paris talks.
Through the meditative faculty, inventions are made possible. Colossal undertakings are carried out. Through it, governments can run smoothly. Through this faculty, man enters into the very kingdom of God. Paris talks.
Meditate on this, O people, and be not of them that wander distraught in the wilderness of error. Kitab-i-Aqdas.
Buddhism.
All the Tathagatas practice self-cultivation through the 18 realms of sense to realize Supreme Bodhi. To them, all these 18 objects of meditation were suitable for their practice. But your quality is inferior, and you are unable to use them to win supreme wisdom. This is why I now teach you to choose a suitable organ for your deep meditation. Once you have entered it and freed yourself from illusion, all your six organs will become pure and clean simultaneously. Tathagatas means Buddhas. Bodhi means awakening, the Surangama Sutra.
Ananda, if all your sense organs are rooted out, your inner light will appear, all transient sense data, as well as the changing conditions of the material world will vanish, like ice melted by boiling water. And you will realize Supreme Bodhi instantly. Bodhi means awakening. The Surangama Sutra.
If you stop all grasping, then there is nothing real. If what is not illusion ceases to arise, where can illusion be? This is the profound lotus dharma or law, the precious Bodhi of the royal gem, the samadhi of seeing all things as illusion, which in a finger snap leads to the state beyond all study. The unsurpassed doctrine was followed by all Bhagavats in all directions on the one path that to nirvana leads. Samadhi means the internal state of imperturbability, achieved through meditation. Bhagavats means the adorable ones. Nirvana means the highest paradise, the Surangama Sutra.
The Buddha said, your six organs should be disengaged in the same way. When you begin to disentangle them, you will realize that the ego is void. When this voidness is perfectly clear, you will realize that all dharma or phenomena are void. When you are disengaged from dharma, the voidness of ego and dharma will vanish. This is called the patient endurance of the uncreate, achieved by means of samadhi and the bodhisattva stage. Samadhi means the internal state of imperturbability achieved through meditation. The Surangama Sutra.
Let the sage first, for some time, coerce his thoughts. Exercise meditation with complete absorption, and correctly perform all that is required for attaining spiritual insight, and then, after rising from his pious meditation, preach with unquailing mind. Lotus Sutra.
By what track can you trace the trackless Buddha of limitless range, in whom exists no longer the entangled and embroiling craving that perpetuates becoming? Those wise ones who are devoted to meditation and who delight in the calm of renunciation, such mindful ones, supreme Buddhas, even the gods hold dear. Dhammapada.
You yourselves must strive. The Buddhas only point the way. Those meditative ones who tread the path are released from the bonds of Mara. Mara means hindrances or demonic forces. Dhammapada.
Wisdom springs from meditation. Without meditation, wisdom wanes. Having known these two paths of progress and decline, let a person so conduct oneself that one's wisdom may increase. Dhammapada.
Those disciples of Gotama, ever awaken happily whose minds by day and night delight in the practice of meditation. Dhammapada.
Meditate, O monk. Do not be heedless. Dhammapada.
One in whom are found both meditative concentration and insight, that one indeed is close to nirvana. Nirvana means the highest paradise. Dhammapada.
One who is meditative and stainless, settles, and whose work is done, free from cankers, having reached the highest goal. Such a one do I call a holy person. Dhammapada.
Gaudai.
Without meditation, how can we develop our wisdom in order to grasp the miraculous truth? First of all, we must focus our mind on a noble thought, then use that light and pure thought to contemplate deeply, to examine thoroughly. Then the wisdom will arise, intuition will surface. At that time, the truth will materialize very clearly and distinctly. Mahayana Dharma.
Christianity.
But his delight is the law of the Lord, and on his law he meditates day and night. Holy Bible.
On my bed I remember you, I think of you through the watches of the night. Because you are my help, I sing in the shadow of your wings. My soul clings to you, your right hand upholds me. Holy Bible.
May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be pleasing in your sight, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Holy Bible.
Within your temple, O God, we meditate on your unfailing love. Holy Bible.
I will remember the deeds of the Lord. Yes, I will remember your miracles of long ago. I will meditate on all your works and consider all your mighty deeds. Your ways, O God, are holy. Holy Bible.
May my meditation be pleasing to him as I rejoice in the Lord. Holy Bible.
I meditate on your precepts and consider your ways. Holy Bible.
Though rulers sit together and slander me, your servant will meditate on your decrees. Holy Bible.
Let me understand the teaching of your precepts. Then I will meditate on your wonders. Holy Bible.
I lift up my hands to your commands, which I love, and I meditate on your decrees. Holy Bible.
May the arrogant be put to shame for wronging me without cause, but I will meditate on your precepts. Holy Bible.
Oh, how I love your law. I meditate on it all day long. Holy Bible.
I have more insight than all my teachers, for I meditate on your statutes. Holy Bible.
My eyes stay open through the watches of the night, that I may meditate on your promises. Holy Bible.
I remember the days of long ago. I meditate on all your works and consider what your hands have done. Holy Bible.
They will speak of the glorious splendor of your majesty, and I will meditate on your wonderful works. Holy Bible.
Gnosticism.
Lighting, then, our torch at the source of that light by the passionate desire which has it for its object, and striving as much as possible to be assimilated to it, we become men full of light. Theodotus. Excerpta ex Theodoto.
Night has spread its veils over us. Everything invites us to meditate. The Gnostic Catechism.
These commandments are suitable for those who meditate repentance, for if they walk not in them, their repentance is in vain. The Shepherd of Hermas.
Agius and Palat and Barshalama and Barsamya, together with the others, their companions, clave to Adias the Apostle, and he received them, and associated them with him in the ministry, their business being to read the Old Testament and the New, and in the Prophets, and in the Acts of the Apostles, and to meditate upon them daily. strictly charging them to let their bodies be pure and their persons holy, as is becoming in men who stand before the altar of God. The teachings of Attius the Apostle.
Hinduism.
The sages, absorbed in meditation, through one-pointedness of mind, discovered the creative power belonging to the Lord Himself and hidden in its own gunas. Gunas means tendencies or modes of operation, creation, preservation, destruction. Sarasvatara Upanishad.
Through constant meditation on Him, by union with Him, by the knowledge of identity with Him, one attains, in the end, cessation of the illusion of phenomena. When the Lord is known, all fetters fall off. With the cessation of miseries, birth and death come to an end. From meditation on Him there arises, after the dissolution of the body, the third state, that of universal lordship. And lastly, the aspirant, transcending that state also, abides in the complete bliss of Brahman. Brahman means the Supreme Self. Svetasvatara Upanishad.
Having received the blessing of the Divine Son, and with minds joined to the Supreme Self, we exert ourselves to the best of our power towards meditation by which we shall attain heaven, or Brahman. Sarasvata Upanishad.
There is a city with 11 gates belonging to the unborn Atman of undistorted consciousness. He who meditates on Him grieves no more. Liberated from the bonds of ignorance, he becomes free. Katha Upanishad.
Brahman is not grasped by the eye, nor by speech, nor by the other senses, nor by penance or good works. A man becomes pure through serenity of intellect. Thereupon, in meditation, he beholds Him who is without parts. Brahman means Supreme Self. Mundaka Upanishad.
The three letters of Om, if employed separately, are mortal, but when joined together in meditation on the total reality and used properly on the activities of the external, internal and intermediate states, the knower trembles not. Prajna Upanishad.
The wise man, meditating on Om, attains this world by means of the Rik verses, the intermediate world by means of the Yajur verses, and that which is known to the seers by means of the Sama verses, and also through the syllable Om, he realizes that which is tranquil, free from decay, death, and fear, and which is the highest. Rig verses, Vajra verses, and Sama verses are verses from the Vedas. Prajna Upanishad.
Therefore, a Brahmin, after he is done with scholarship, should try to live on that strength which comes of scholarship. After he is done with that strength and scholarship, he becomes meditative. And after he is done with both meditativeness and non-meditativeness, he becomes a knower of Brahman. Brahmin means a member of a cultural and social elite. Brahman means Supreme Self. Brihadaranyaka Upanishad.
Verily, my dear Maitreyi, it is the self that should be realized, should be heard of, reflected on, and meditated upon. By the realization of the self, my dear, through hearing, reflection, and meditation, all this is known. Brihadaranyaka Upanishad.
Next follows the meditation on Brahman through the gods. One should meditate on Brahman as satisfaction in rain, as power in lightning, as light in the stars, as procreation, immortality and joy in the organ of generation, and as everything in the akasa. Let him contemplate Brahman as the support, and he will be supported. Let him contemplate Brahman as greatness, and he will become great. Let him contemplate Brahman as the mind, and he will be endowed with mind. Brahman means Supreme Self. Akasa means ether or atmosphere. Taittiriya Upanishad.
He who thus knows the Udgita or Om and meditates on it, his life shall be the most excellent in this world and likewise in the other world. Yea, the other world. Chandogya Upanishad.
Meditation or dhyana is verily greater than consideration, earth meditates, as it were. The mid-region meditates, as it were. Heaven meditates, as it were. The waters meditate, as it were. The mountains meditate, as it were. The gods meditate, as it were. Men meditate, as it were. Therefore, he who among men attains greatness here on earth seems to have obtained a share of meditation. Thus, while small people are quarrelsome, abusive, and slandering, great men appear to have obtained a share of meditation. Meditate on meditation. Chandogya Upanishad.
The sound which he thus practices makes him deaf to all external sounds. Having overcome all obstacles, he enters the Turiya state within 15 days. Turiya means a name of the transcendental Brahman, which both transcends and pervades the three states of waking, dream, and deep sleep. Narabindu Upanishad.
In the beginning of his practice, he hears many loud sounds. They gradually increase in pitch and are heard more and more subtly. At first, the sounds are like those proceeding from the ocean, clouds, kettle drum, and cataracts. In the middle stage, those proceeding from the mardala, a musical instrument, bell and horn. At the last stage, those proceeding from tinkling bells, flute, veena, a musical instrument, and bees. Thus he hears many such sounds more and more subtle. Nada Bindu Upanishad.
Hua Hao Buddhism.
As taught by the Buddhas, past and present, in the false body there is a true one. Sentient beings should still their mind. That true body they will be able to find. Illuminating the way too.
When we use the right contemplation, to put aside all worries and sorrows, destroying all the temptations which drag us onto the wrong path, then our heart isn't disturbed. Our mind shines like the full moon, a bright and clear hue, uncontaminated by external conditions, completely detached from all mundane matters, and gradually will arrive at the realm of liberation. Prophecy to expound literature and poetry.
International Society of Krishna Consciousness.
As a lamp in a windless place does not waver, so the transcendentalist, whose mind is controlled, remains always steady in his meditation on the transcendent self. Bhagavad Gita.
In the stage of perfection called trance, or samadhi, one's mind is completely restrained from material mental activities by practice of yoga. This perfection is characterized by one's ability to see the self by the pure mind and to relish and rejoice in the self. In that joyous state, one is situated in boundless transcendental happiness, realized through transcendental senses. Established thus, one never departs from the truth, and upon gaining this, he thinks there is no greater gain. Being situated in such a position, one is never shaken, even in the midst of greatest difficulty. This indeed is actual freedom from all miseries arising from material contact. Bhagavad Gita.
But those who worship me, giving up all their activities unto me, and being devoted to me without deviation, engaged in devotional service, and always meditating upon me, having fixed their minds upon me, O son of Pritha, for them I am the swift deliverer from the ocean of birth and death. Bhagavad Gita.
Better than knowledge, however, is meditation, and better than meditation is renunciation of the fruits of action, for by such renunciation one can attain peace of mind. Bhagavad Gita.
When the mind disciplined by the practice of meditation becomes steady, one becomes content in the self by beholding him with purified intellect. One feels infinite bliss that is perceivable only through the intellect and is beyond the reach of the senses. After realizing Brahman, one is never separated from absolute reality. After self-realization, one does not regard any other gain superior to self-realization. Established in self-realization, one is not moved even by the greatest calamity. Brahman means Supreme Self. Bhagavad Gita.
Islam.
1 hour's meditation on the work of the Creator is better than 70 years of prayer. Hadith.
Who remember Allah while standing or sitting or lying on their sides and meditate upon the creation of the heavens and the earth, saying, Our Lord, you did not create this aimlessly. Exalted are you above such a thing, then protect us from the punishment of the fire. Holy Quran.
Jainism.
Uttara Palguni, the Venerable One, in a squatting position with joined heels, exposing himself to the heat of the sun, after fasting 2.5 days without drinking water, being engaged in deep meditation, reached the highest knowledge and intuition called Kevala, which is infinite, supreme, unobstructed, unimpeded, complete and full. Kalpa Sutra.
As the luster of a burning flame increases, so increase the austerity, wisdom, and glory of a steadfast sage who, with vanquished desires, meditates on the supreme place of virtue. Akaranga Sutra.
But this is the best law, silently to meditate, even if badly treated. Akaranga Sutra.
And Mahavira meditated, preserving in some posture, without the smallest motion. He meditated in mental concentration on the things above, below, beside, free from desires. He meditated free from sin and desire, not attached to sounds or colors. Though still an erring mortal, or kadmastha, he wandered about and never acted carelessly, himself understanding the truth and restraining the impulses for the purification of the soul. Finally liberated and free from delusion, the Venerable One was well guarded during his whole life. Akaranga Sutra.
In these places was the wise Sramana. For 13 long years he meditated day and night, exerting himself undisturbed, strenuously. Sramana means a wandering monk. Jaina Sutras.
Sometimes the Venerable One did not drink for half a month, or even for a month. Or he did not drink for more than 2 months, or even 6 months, day and night, without desire, for drink. Sometimes he ate stale food. Sometimes he ate only the sixth meal, or the eighth, the tenth, the twelfth, without desires, persevering in meditation. Jaina Sutras.
Neglecting his body, the venerable ascetic, Mahavira, meditated on his self, in blameless lodgings, in blameless wandering, in restraint, kindness, avoidance of sinful influence, or samvara, chaste life, in patience, freedom from passion, contentment, control, circumspectness, practicing religious postures and acts, walking the path of nirvana and liberation, which is the fruit of good conduct. Nirvana means the highest paradise. Jaina Sutras.
Meditation verily must be performed in right belief, knowledge, and conduct, but all three are the soul. Therefore, perform meditation in the pure soul itself. Samayasara.
The saint who is always attentive to this soul meditation follows true right conduct. He attains liberation from all troubles in a short time. Samayasara.
One free from infatuation and attachment has pure meditation. Ashtapahuda.
The best of saints who keep the 5 great vows have subdued the 5 senses, are without desire, and engaged in study and meditation, love such places. Ashtapahuda.
Meditate on the 5 kinds of knowledge, which quickly destroy ignorance. The soul that does it in the proper spirit becomes the repository of bliss in heaven or emancipation. Ashtapahuda.
As a torch burns in an inner room free from disturbance by wind, so does a torch of meditation burn when free from the wind of attachment. Ashtapahuda.
Knowing and always experiencing whom the yogi poised in meditation attains nirvana, a state free from suffering, everlasting, and incomparable. Nirvana means the highest paradise. Ashtabhuda.
Giving up wrong belief, ignorance, bad and good deeds, in three ways, thought, word and deed, and keeping the vow of silence, the yogi poised in meditation illumines the self. Ashtabhuda.
The yogi having devotion for God and preceptor, love for co-religionists and righteous people, and self-realization is absorbed in meditation. Ashtabhuda.
Devotees of God and the preceptor, bearing in mind the traditions of non-attachment, absorbed in meditation with rectitude of conduct, such people are on the way to emancipation. Ashtabhuda.
The ascetics observe complete vows. They have a high density. They are unattached to worldly pleasures. They practice the 12 meditations, which give births to renunciation. Kahadala.
The joy of equanimity is aroused by such meditations, like a flame caused by wind. When the soul knows itself, it attains eternal bliss. Chahadala.
Judaism.
Do not let this book of the law depart from your mouth. Meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. Then you will be prosperous and successful. Holy Nevi'im.
And Isaac went out to meditate in the field at the eventide. Holy Torah.
And Moses entered into the midst of the cloud and went up into the mount. And Moses was in the mount 40 days and 40 nights. Holy Torah.
I will meditate in thy precepts and have respect unto thy ways. Holy Ketuvim.
I will lift up my hands also unto thy commandments, which I have loved, and I will meditate in thy statutes. Holy Ketuvim.
Mine eyes forestalled the night watches, that I might meditate in thy word. Holy Ketuvim.
Oh, how love I thy law! It is my meditation all the day. Holy Ketuvim.
I have more understanding than all my teachers, for thy testimonies are my meditation. Holy Ketuvim.
Native American spirituality.
Her attitude in secret meditations must be such as to instill into the receptive soul of the unborn child the love of the great mystery and a sense of brotherhood with all creation. Silence and isolation are the rule of life for the expectant mother. The soul of the Indian.
His sickness afforded him much time for serious meditation, and it is quite possible that some of his precepts are the result of this opportunity. The Code of Handsome Lake, the Seneca Prophet.
Sangha of Bhikkhu Buddhist Association.
Although spiritual practitioners do not study books, literature, or history, they still understand clearly the logic of life. Their thorough understanding is due to samadhi, meditation, and from which their intuition arises. Naturally, their wisdom develops and helps them to perceive things quickly. Therefore, although they don't study, they just naturally know. Book of Truth.
A spiritual practitioner needs meditation first and foremost. Through meditation, he will be able to contemplate on the natural law of creation and fathom the impermanent nature of things. Then he will clearly understand, perceive, that life is just a long dream. Book of Truth.
Shintoism.
The Bodhisattva, Prince Shotoku, often meditated and entered samadhi, sometimes for one day, sometimes for 3 days or 5 days. At that time, people didn't know what meditation was, so they said the prince entered the dream hall. Samadhi means the internal state of imperturbability achieved through meditation. The biography of Prince Shotoku Bodhisattva.
Master Xuanzang told monk Dao Zhao, "The scriptures are profound and incomprehensible. It's impossible to realize their ultimate essences. You'd better learn the way of meditation, or Zen, and spread this method in Japan. Monk Dao Zhao followed this instruction and started to learn meditation, and then he became more enlightened. Shoku Nihongi.
Sikhism.
Nanak celebrates in bliss, chanting and meditating on the Lord. All sickness has been cured. Holy Guru Granth Sahib.
Meditate in remembrance of the one universal creator. The true Lord created the entire universe. The Guru controls the air, water, and fire. He has staged the drama of the world. Reflect on your own self, and so practice good conduct. Chant the name of the Lord as your self-discipline in meditation. The name of the Lord is your companion, friend, and dear beloved. Chant it, and meditate on it. Holy Guru Granth Sahib.
Whoever receives this grace contemplates him in meditation. He is not burned by the fire of the world. Holy Guru Granth Sahib.
Meditate in remembrance of the Lord. Meditate on the Lord. This alone shall be of use to you. Holy Guru Granth Sahib.
Meditate on the Lord. Vibrate on the Lord. Your life is slipping away. Holy Guru Granth Sahib.
Excruciating pain, countless killings, reincarnation, poverty, and terrible misery are all destroyed by meditating in remembrance of the Lord's name. O Nanak, just as fire reduces piles of wood to ashes, meditating in remembrance on the Lord, the darkness is illuminated. Dwelling on His glorious praises, the ugly sins are destroyed. Holy Guru Granth Sahib.
Wherever the Lord's devotee goes is a blessed, beautiful place. All comforts are obtained, meditating on the Lord's name. Holy Guru Granth Sahib.
They are liberated. They are liberated. Those who meditate on the Lord. For them, the noose of death is cut away. Those who meditate on the Fearless One, on the Fearless Lord, all their fears are dispelled. Blessed are they, who meditate on their dear Lord. Holy Guru Granth Sahib.
With my palms pressed together, I offer my prayer within my mind. I meditate on the Supreme Lord God. Giving me His hand, the Transcendent Lord has eradicated all my sins. Holy Guru Granth Sahib.
When chanting, austere meditation and self-discipline become your protectors, then the lotus blossoms forth and the honey trickles out. Holy Guru Granth Sahib.
Swedenborgianism.
An expanding awareness of spiritual reality is encouraged by the exploration of dreams and by prayer and meditation practices. Tenets of Swedenborgianism.
Once, when I was meditating about the Lord's second coming, there suddenly appeared a flash of light, which forcibly struck my eyes, and I therefore looked up, and lo, the whole heaven above me appeared luminous, and there, from the east to the west, in a continuous strain, a glorification was heard. True Christian religion.
Theosophy.
Perchance, this is justified on that principle of the scientific theory which teaches us about light and sound and the effect of two waves of equal length meeting. If the two sounds be of the same intensity, their coincidence produces a sound four times the intensity of either, while their interference produces absolute silence. The secret doctrine.
He who unveils through study and meditation its intricate paths, and throws light on those dark ways, in the windings of which so many men perish, owing to their ignorance of the labyrinth of life, is working for the good of his fellow men. The secret doctrine.
He who would hear the voice of Nada, the soundless sound, and comprehend it, he has to learn the nature of Dharana. Having become indifferent to objects of perception, the pupil must seek out the Raja of the senses, the thought producer, he who awakes illusion. Dharana means unbending concentration of mind. Raja means king. The voice of the silence.
Tibetan Buddhism.
ripening karma brings to them an instinctive hatred. Failing to distinguish right from wrong, they can hardly be helped by any means. Bear, O my disciples, this in your minds, and meditate with perseverance all your lives. 60 Songs of Milarepa.
Heed the bounty of your guru, and avoid all sinful deeds. Casting worldly things aside, stay firm in your practice. Keep your good vows, and devote your life to meditation. 60 Songs of Milarepa.
Have you prepared and lit your lamp? Should it not be ready, meditate on the great light. 60 Songs of Milarepa.
Practicing meditation in solitude is, in itself, a service to the people. 60 Songs of Milarepa.
Through the practice of meditation, I show gratitude to my guru. Pray, grant me your grace, ripen and liberate me. 60 Songs of Milarepa.
One should turn all one's Buddhist knowledge inside one's mouth and then meditate. If one does not further one's studies and meditation at the same time, but thinks that one should first learn a great deal before starting the actual practice, one will be completely lost, because knowledge is infinite, and there is no possibility of mastering it all. 60 Songs of Milarepa.
By looking inward into the mind, is seen mind nature, without substance, intrinsically void. Through meditation in solitude, the grace of the succession gurus and the teaching of the great Naropa are attained. The inner truth of the Buddha should be the object of meditation. Naropa was Marpa's master, the master of Milarepa, the 100,000 songs of Milarepa.
Illumination, non-thought and non-distraction are the quintessence of meditation. The 100,000 songs of Milarepa.
Deep in the forest by man untrod, I, Milarepa, happily practice meditation. With no attachment and no clinging, walking and tranquility are both pleasing. Free from sickness and disorder, I willingly sustain this body of illusion. Never sleeping, I sit in the comfort of quietude. Abiding in the samadhi of non-permanence, I taste enjoyment. Continuance in heat yoga without cold is indeed felicitous. Samadhi means the inner state of imperturbability, achieved through meditation, the 100,000 songs of Milarepa.
Happy is the path of both wisdom and means. Happy the yoga of arising and perfecting, the meditation of the two in one. Happy the prajna, the awareness of no coming and going. Happy the absence of talk, no friends and no chatting. These are the pleasures of words. Happy is the understanding of non-grasping. Happy is the meditation without interruption. Happy is the accomplishment without hope or fear. Happy the action done without defilement. These are pleasures of mind. Prajna means wisdom. The 100,000 songs of Milarepa.
This little song of great happiness that flows freely from my heart is inspired by meditation. By the merging of act and knowledge, those who aim at the fruit of Bodhi or Buddhahood may follow this way of yogic practice. The 100,000 songs of Milarepa.
Because of my human fear of death, I meditate on immortal mind, absorbed in the uncreated realm. The keystone of the principle I practice is self-liberation from samsara. With this quintessence of all teachings, I clearly see awareness, naked and unsubstantial. My confidence in the view is the transparency of flux. Since I know the illuminating void, I fear not life or death. Samsara means the cycle of reincarnation. The 100,000 songs of Milarepa.
Through constant meditation on the Bodhi mind, I eradicate forever the obscuring shadows of habitual thoughts. Whatever may appear before me, I see as false illusions. Thus I fear not the three miserable paths. Bodhi means awakening. The 100,000 songs of Milarepa.
Urged by Marpa, Milarepa devoted his life to meditation. The 100,000 songs of Milarepa.
The bardo of birth and death is a good ground on which to drill the illuminating mind. Upon it, one should practice the arising and perfecting yogas. Bardo means state of existence between death and rebirth. The 100,000 songs of Milarepa.
The bardo of dream and sleep is best, to convert habitual thinking into wisdom. Within it, one should practice the yogas of light and of the phantom body. At the end of the Siddha Bardo, the three bodies of Buddha will appear. This is the time to enter the three pure lands. Bardo means state of existence between death and rebirth. The 100,000 songs of Milarepa.
By waking from past karma or retribution and perfecting meditation, he will gain liberation soon. The 100,000 songs of Milarepa.
He who can watch his mind without distraction needs no talk or chat. He who can absorb himself in self-awareness need not sit stiffly like a corpse. If one knows the nature of all forms, the eight worldly desires will vanish of themselves. If not desire or hatred is within his heart, he needs no pretense or show. The great wisdom and trikaya that transcends samsara and nirvana both can never be achieved by search and aspiration. Never can one attain them without first receiving blessing from the lineage. Trikaya means three bodies of the Buddha. Samsara means cycle of reincarnation. Nirvana means highest paradise. The 100,000 songs of Milarepa.
When I practice Mahamudra, I rest myself in the intrinsic state, relaxingly without distraction or effort. In the realm of voidness, I rest myself with illumination. In the realm of blissfulness, I rest myself in awareness. In the realm of non-thought, I rest myself with a naked mind. In manifestations and activities, I rest myself in samadhi. Meditating on the mind essence in such a manner, numerous understandings and convictions arise. By self-illumination, all is accomplished without effort. Looking no more for enlightenment, I am extremely happy. Free from both hope and fear, I feel very joyful. Oh, what a pleasure it is to enjoy confusion when as wisdom it appears. Mahamudra means the great seal. Samadhi means the internal state of imperturbability, achieved through meditation. The 100,000 songs of Milarepa.
If I did not meet my guru, how could I have received the pith instructions? Without instructions, how could I meditate in solitude? Without meditating in solitude, how could the inner experience and realization arise? The 100,000 songs of Milarepa.
The Universal White Brotherhood.
Listen to the still, small voice which speaks to your hearts. This is God's voice. On the earth, there is not one human being to whom this voice does not speak. The meaning of life.
For more details, please visit www.suprememastertv.com/WOW-scrolls.